is Cataclysm going to come about? Are we going to see like
some type of patches,
some type of phasing, some type of big world event? I think that's still a very much an unanswered question. You know, we are going to have to wait to see how exactly the new itemization is going to play out, so forth. And definitely when looking at the systems panel that we saw, you know, today on DirecTV just shortly, they almost, in my mind, introduced a game within a game, which was, you know, the guild leveling system. And that's something that definitely is going to make me rethink the game and rethink the way that I play the game.
Absolutely. We also had Felicia Day join us to talk about the brand new season of The Guild. We showed the first trailer for that. That'll be up on Xbox Live. The first episode will be up on Tuesdays. So people will be able to check that out.
It's
great to see, you know, the fan community that gets around here. And let's not forget, obviously, the costume contest last night, the dance contest, Machinima, Soundalike contest. Joe, you got to see a lot of that stuff with us last night.
I got to see some insane...
Riverdance seemed to win, right?
That was great.
Exactly.
The Riverdance was great, but you have to give it up to MC Hammer. Did you see Hammer?
Yes.
He came out with one of my favorites.
He had a costume for the dance contest.
Yeah.
Like, it was serious. And then the costumes out on the floor, we had the cow level was present.
Yeah,
cow
level's always present, I feel here. You know, everyone wants to know where that Diablo cow level is.
You would think that Blizzard hired them because they were being stopped every few inches from people wanting to take pictures with them. It was like they needed their own security out there.
Yeah. They did.
But it's very interesting what they go through. We had people who'd spent 500 hours to design their costumes.
Crazy.
The girl that actually won the costume contest, it took her a whole year to make that costume. And she said it weighed close to 80 pounds.
How did she get it here, did she say?
A couple people brought it with her, but she had the whole entire costume on wheels. So, like, if you lifted up the dress, you can see that it's on, like, a little harness. So she got smart about it. It was still pretty heavy, being that it was on wheels, but she still managed to get around. She was actually physically walking in that costume.
Huh.
So it was interesting, all the trouble that they go through. I mean, these are hardcore fans to spend that kind of time and dedication. People don't even spend that kind of time customizing their cars. So it was good to see.
And then bringing it here sometimes across the country or around the world. I mean, it's been amazing to see, you know, fans we've spoken to from places as far away as Australia. I know this.
A lot of Australians here.
Exactly, a lot of Australians. And, you know, over 100 countries have been watching us on DirecTV and the internet stream. So it really is a worldwide event when Blizzard makes these announcements. And then it was great today to see, you know, additional announcements coming out, like the StarCraft II voice cast. A lot of, you know, questions around who was going to play Kerrigan, because we announced the original actress that did that role in StarCraft was not going to return. Everyone was wondering who was it going to be.
And then finally,
Chris Metzen at the end of the panel announced, you know, our final guest would be Trisha Helfer from Battlestar Galactica.
She has such a distinctive voice, too,
exactly.
So it's well recognized. And I think Kerrigan's voice, for me, like when she was doing her ghosting back at the very, very first game in the original StarCraft, like you grow to love her in the very first game. She doesn't spend a lot of time in the first game, but at the same time, that voice, it's very distinct. So I'm hoping that with the new changes and the new voiceover that it'll be just as, like, just as memorable. It's important. It's part of the environment of the video game.
With all and those Chris in-game cinematics, it looks amazing.
It will. And I think Chris Metzen made a really good point about her casting and that, you know, what she did with Battlestar Galactica was play, you know, the good and the evil. She definitely had both characters. And so to be able to roll that into the storytelling in StarCraft II seems like it's going to be a pivotal part of what they're trying to do.
Yeah, we can't wait to hear more about it. Now, we are just moments away from Ozzy Osbourne taking the stage here to close out BlizzCon 2009. The stage is set. I understand we're very close to Ozzy, the Prince of Darkness, arriving at BlizzCon. Are you guys in the hall ready for Ozzy Osbourne? All right, you can hear the crowd cheer. They are getting excited for
the
Prince of Darkness.
They're ready to ride the crazy train.
Exactly, ride the crazy train. And Ozzy has a special guest we saw in the rehearsal. I don't think we can tell you who it is, but there's someone who might rock out with Ozzy, which will surprise everyone. A very talented individual.
I hope so.
Exactly. All right, guys. Well, it's been great bringing you DirecTV's uninterrupted coverage of BlizzCon live in high definition over 18 hours. And now it's the moment everyone has been waiting for with Ozzy Osbourne live on stage here at BlizzCon. He's got a full set for you guys. He's going to rock the house. I know fans are excited. And we're going to go right over there now to the main hall for the Prince of Darkness and his arrival here at BlizzCon. You guys enjoy this, and we'll be back with you after the concert for our closing thoughts as we close out an amazing 2009 BlizzCon from here in Anaheim, California. Over 26,000 fans from around the world assembled here, and now everyone is gathered in the main hall to see Ozzy Osbourne close it as only he can. I mean, there have been so many many great bands over the years of the Dying. Remember the first BlizzCon with the Offspring.
Right.
And now to have Ozzy Osbourne here.
I don't know where we go from here. This is it.
I don't know.
We had a great 2009 BlizzCon, so we have to go out with a bang. So.
And I think Ozzy's going to do that.
I think he's going to bring it.
He's got a few surprises in his set from what I've heard and all the classics that everyone's going to want to hear.
I hope those people in the front of the house are prepared. That's all I can say. I don't think you are. You are not prepared.
You are not prepared for the Prince of Darkness, what he's got to say.
It's about time.
It's about time for Ozzy Osbourne. It's going to be a great show, so you guys enjoy it over there in the main hall. And, of course, we'll be bringing you all of Ozzy's great songs right here on DirecTV in high definition and also on the Internet. And those of you that are watching this stream on the Internet that don't have DirecTV, you can go to DirecTV.com if you want to learn more about subscribing to DirecTV for all the latest entertainment, sports, and technology information. DirecTV is the place to go for great broadcasts like this live in high definition.
Every year.
You can only do it here.
You can only do it here. Exactly. The fans are getting excited. The Prince of Darkness is backstage preparing right now.
Everyone's getting anxious. The crowd is getting excited.
I think people are getting ready for Ozzy with all the classic hits. You know, Ozzy has just had such a resurgence over the past decade, I feel like. And now, you know, with his songs, he's also, see him in a brand new game called Brutal Legend he's going to be in. He's going to be a voice in that game. And you've got, you know, obviously songs from him in Guitar Hero and titles like that, Black Sabbath. I mean, it's just been, I think everyone knows his songs from back in the day, but now to re-experience these songs and all these music games,
and with his show, people grew to love him. Like, right. You got to see a different side of Ozzy when you see him every day at home.
Seems like a very likable Prince of Darkness, I must say.
And I heard he's a big World of Warcraft fan. Someone was telling me he sometimes can play 8 to 9 hours a day sometimes of World of Warcraft.
That's pretty hardcore.
That's what people say about Ozzy Osbourne. So he is going to be amongst his friends and his fellow Blizzard fans here when he takes the stage live on DirecTV in just moments. Well, it looks like the fans are getting ready. Everyone is lined up. There's standing room only crowds here getting ready for Ozzy.
I don't hear him cheering.
We're starting
Where's the excitement, guys? Ozzy wants to hear you.
Maybe if you cheer, he'll come out.
Exactly. I think they're just waiting, but it's great. You've actually got standing room only right at the front.
Everyone is ready.
People are getting excited. There's the drum set. I know. You got to go over there, Joe. You can go and dance right up at the front. Come on. We need to go over there.
He's actually been here. He was here with a full rehearsal a couple days ago, which about a handful of Blizzard employees were able to see, and it was a very special opportunity for both our DirecTV crew and Blizzard employees to be able to have a private concert from Ozzy Osbourne. It was about 5 songs.
He was rocking it out.
He was rocking it out. And then the night before that, it was just a rehearsal with his band. So it's felt like a weekend of Ozzy.
Exactly. Well, Samwise was telling me, I mean, that was one of the highlights for him of the week, was that, you know, moment with, it literally was about 100 people as Ozzy was doing his sound check and making sure that everything was going to be just right for the Blizzard fans here.
There was probably 100 people sitting in the audience, and Samwise was in the front row, standing up, rocking out as if he was at a big concert. He was having a great time, I got to tell you.
You never know. Maybe they're going to put Ozzy in one of the games now, because, you know, they did all those commercials
with him
where he was, you know, I'm the real Prince of Darkness.
He's definitely undead.
Exactly. Yeah. Maybe we will see him, the Ozzy Unlockable, or Ozzy doing a voice. If Trisha Helfer can do a voice, why can't we have Ozzy one of these games? We even interviewed
Frank Pierce on the floor, and he showed me his earplugs. Like, he's ready. Like, he has his earplugs in his pocket, and he had his Ozzy Osbourne shirt on today.
You know,
so he's ready to go. He's concert ready.
I have to tell you, I think that the earplugs were a wise idea.
Well, people were telling me they were, you know, as you mentioned before, they were monitoring the sound, and it was going to be 120 decibels here for Ozzy.
It's starting to get loud
here at Anaheim Convention Center. The fans are clapping. They are calling for Ozzy, and he's getting ready to come out and rock the house here as we wrap things up on DirecTV. I mean, when I look back over the past 2 days, I know this has been something that all the fans have really been waiting for, that ultimate moment to celebrate all things Blizzard after 2 days of fun and games.
Sounds like something's
happening. The crowd is going crazy,
and I think it
looks like we're getting very close to Ozzy Osbourne rocking the house to close it out. Is that Ozzy I hear?
It's someone.
I think the Prince of Darkness has arrived. Enjoy it. It's Ozzy
Osbourne
live on DirecTV.
This is live. Foxconn, please welcome the original Prince of Darkness, Ozzy Osbourne!
Are you ready to go fucking wild tonight?